Hey everyone, Zian over here from Nintendo Life, and we're happy to share with you that the long-awaited island backup service for Animal Crossing New Horizons is finally here. And while it may seem like a fairly simple task to initiate, we figured some of you may want to learn exactly how to get it set up on your Switch so that your island will be safe and sound in case of an emergency. So without further ado, let's get that beautiful island of yours the backup it deserves. So the first step to getting the island backup service running on Animal Crossing New Horizons is to make sure that you have an active Nintendo Switch Online membership. An active Nintendo Switch Online membership is required to initiate the island backup service. And at the moment, we don't know if you need to maintain an active membership in the off chance that you do need to re-download your island later on. But we'll make sure to update our guide whenever we learn if that's true or not. Step 2 is to make sure that your Animal Crossing New Horizons game data is updated to version 1.4 or higher. You can confirm this by highlighting the Animal Crossing icon on your home menu and then pressing the plus button on your controller. The current version of your game will be displayed on the upper portion of the screen. And if you're currently running an older version of the game, you can update it by simply clicking the software update option on the screen. As long as your Switch is connected to the internet, your system will search for an update and download it momentarily. The speed of the download will vary based on how long it's been since you've updated the game, but then once it's been updated, feel free to just open up the game. Step 3 is to go into the settings of the Animal Crossing menu. Once on the home screen of Animal Crossing New Horizons, you can visit the system settings by pressing the minus button. Once there, you'll be treated to a dark room occupied by the raccoon tanuki overlord, Tom Nook. Once there, you can click on the island backup option to learn more about the service and to enable it as well. Once you've read over all the fine print, you can go ahead and ask Nook to enable island backup. It only takes a brief moment before it activates. And once you go back to the Animal Crossing New Horizons home screen, you'll notice in the bottom left corner of the screen that the island backup service is enabled. So now that we have the island backup service enabled, how do we actually know when our island is actually being backed up? And that's where step 4 comes into play. Periodically, when you're not playing Animal Crossing New Horizons, your Switch will upload your island data to Nintendo servers, and you can confirm this whenever you revisit the Animal Crossing New Horizons home menu. We suggest closing out your game for 5 minutes or so, and then reopening the game to see if your data has been uploaded. Once it has, you'll be able to see the time and date of the last time it was uploaded in the bottom left corner. It also goes without saying that your data can only be backed up when you're connected to the internet. But if you happen to have your Switch offline for a while, once it reconnects to the internet, it should just upload a backup of your most recent island data. And once you've gone through all these steps, your island should be safely stored within Nintendo's database in case of any emergency. But what if the day actually comes where you need to access that backup? And if that happens, then we have one more step for you. In order to prevent players from trying to manipulate the system data, Nintendo is being extremely strict with how they allow you to re-download your island data. Details are scarce at the moment, but from what we can gather, you can only re-download your island data if your Switch has been stolen, gone missing, was damaged, and you've purchased a replacement, or if your Switch has been repaired by Nintendo directly. You'll also need to contact Nintendo to have them help you with re-downloading your island. And there you have it, just a few short steps to securing your getaway Animal Crossing island from a potential catastrophe. Feel free to let us know in the comments down below if you're happy with the option Nintendo has given the community to keep their island safe, or let us know if you'd prefer a different method. And as always, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more content like this, then why don't you go ahead and make a backup of that subscribe button, and then ring that notification bell to be notified whenever we release new videos. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm Zian from Nintendo Life. Please stay safe out there, and we will see you next time.